to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to try to tackle a question that I always get a lot, and that is when people are following the videos of how to register new countries or cities, they ask me, where do I find my country code? So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to navigate all of that to be able to accomplish all your coding goals, especially in WooCommerce. If you're interested in seeing videos that will help you navigate your WordPress or WooCommerce and help you come up with solutions, this is the channel for you, so consider subscribing or even giving a like to the video if you find it helpful. So let's jump into the solution. So I have my editor open here and I have one of my local install of WordPress and WooCommerce right here. So I'll go in the WP content folder. I'm going to go into my plugins folder, and then I'm going to open up my WooCommerce. So I'll open this up and drop it inside my editor. And once I open this up, you'll see we have a folder which is called I18 for internationalization. And when you open it, you'll be able to see the continents.php file that shows you all the different continents that are available. And then it shows you the different country codes. So for example, if you're in Africa, you'll see this in the AF. If you're in Antarctica, you'll be able to see this in AN. And Asia, you'll be able to see all these different continents that are highlighted for you to be able to pick up your country code. So if you're in Asia, let's say you want to see whether you're in Sri Lanka, it is the LK version. Now, how am I sure this is so? If I go to the countries.php, you'll be able to quickly do a search. So for example, I'm going to look for Sri Lanka, and you'll see that Sri Lanka is actually an LK, and it is the country we are looking for. So there are so many other countries. If you can't find your own country, I have a video that shows you how to add your country, and it's listed in the video description down below. Now, if you want to see more information, let's say like the states that are in your particular country, I'm going to go to states, and then I'll look for Sri Lanka, which we noted that it is LK. We'll be able to see a number of LKs in here. So I'm going to just scroll down, and you'll see that Sri Lanka actually doesn't have any particular states that are in here. Now, if you want to have the next releases of WooCommerce having Sri Lanka states in here, you can actually go and contribute this on the WooCommerce repo, and that's where we're going to go for now. So if I go to my browser and then I type github.com/WooCommerce, and then I'll go /WooCommerce and hit enter, you'll be able to see a similar repo that has WooCommerce in here. Now you can contribute to the WooCommerce by following the contribution guide that they do have here on how to add the different countries, or you can make a formal request giving all the information that's needed. So similarly, like we saw in our editor here, we had an I18N folder. We have the same folder here. So meaning you can get the same information from this same folder on the GitHub repo. So if I click I18N here, you'll see we have our continents, we have our countries, we have our states in here. And if I go to the states and just Control F and look for LK, which is Sri Lanka, you will see that it's also empty here. So you can be able to submit so that all the subsequent versions of WooCommerce will have Sri Lanka with the states in there. But if you look at all the other states like Tanzania, you will see that it has all the different listed states, which are like the second level administrative division of the country. So you'll see that you have Dodoma, Arusha, Dar es Salaam, all those are listed here in Tanzania. So we can build on Sri Lanka by submitting in here, or we can actually just use this video that I created on how to add new cities and new states inside WooCommerce. Let me jump into that code to help you see how to make that better. So since we don't have anything listed in our Sri Lanka for now, let me try to add new states inside our Sri Lanka country. I'm going to stay in my editor here. I'll open up a new plugins folder inside my installation, and I'm going to call it Sri Lanka states. And after doing that, I'll drag this and drop it inside my editor. I'll add it to my workspace. And inside here, I'm going to open up a new file, which I'll call Sri Lanka-states.php. So the first thing we'll do is open our PHP here. So after writing our PHP, I'm going to use my shortcut. So this shortcut will allow me to add my comments in here. So I'll call this Sri Lanka States. I'll change these links to my GitHub repo. So github.com/yttechiepress. And then what I'm going to do next here is I'll add my author name and I'll say I am Techiepress. And then we'll just say add Sri Lanka States in here, add Sri Lanka States. And then I'm going to give it a version of 0.1 and I'll say this is GPL 2 or later for the particular license. I'm going to just copy this and I'll make it my particular plugin text domain. So after doing that, I'm going to hit save here. I'm going to go to my local server. I'll open up the admin. As the admin opens up, I'm also going to look for the Sri Lanka States on Google. Now that our admin is open, I'm going to go to the plugins. And inside the plugins, I'm going to activate our Sri Lanka States right here. Now, of course, this is not going to do much of a change because we've not written any kind of code. So let me go to WooCommerce and go to the settings. And then I'll go to the shipping. And then I'm going to try to add a shipping zone in here. And you'll see that when I try to type for Sri Lanka, we're only getting Sri Lanka showing up here. So I'm going to try to add a couple of things. So I'll come back here to my code. And then the first thing that I'll do is add some simple security to my plugin and say if the app's path is defined, then we should continue. If it's not defined, then we should say, let this plugin stop running. Now we're going to use a filter. So we'll say add filter. And this is a default functionality of WordPress. We're going to have a filter called WooCommerce States. And inside the states, we're going to just say we want to have a Techiepress Sri Lanka States addition. So that's going to be our function that we shall write. We shall copy this. And then here I'll add a function right here. And then I'm going to add our brackets. I'll add our brackets, and in here is where we shall write our code. Now we are going to be receiving some states from that filter, and we want to be able to tap that states. Then we are going to return it as the first thing. So states should be returned. So after getting the states here, the first thing we shall do is say, let's get our states variable. And we're going to say, this states is actually an array. And inside this array, we're going to look for the LK, which is our Sri Lanka country. So on this Sri Lanka, we shall say, we're going to add an array. And we shall say, our array is actually going to equal to a number of items. So in here, we're going to start giving particular IDs to, let's say, we shall say our first ID will be LK001, and we shall say that's going to be, let me just look up Sri Lanka as a country. I'll Google up Sri Lanka, and you're going to find that it has a city called Colombo, and then you'll see we have a number of other countries to it. So let me go back to my code, and I'm going to say LK1 is going to be Colombo. I'll add another LK002, and say that's going to be, and we'll just take another city. I'm not sure whether this is a city or something, but I'm going to just go for Kandy and Matale. So in here we shall have Matale, put a comma, and then I'm going to go for LK003, of course map onto that, and say that one is going to be Kandy. So add a comma here and save this. So once I save this, I should be able to go back to my administrative area. I'll reload this. I'll say leave. I'll reload this page. And when I come here and type Sri Lanka, you'll see that we have Colombo, Matale, and Kandy. So I can be able to actually just even type Matale, and you'll see that it comes up in Sri Lanka. So those can be my new shipping zones. I can have them as cities on my page. And that is because I was able to figure out that when you come to WooCommerce in the I-18, you should be able to go to the states, and then you'll find out the different country codes, or you can actually go to the countries and you'll find the different countries and the code that you're looking for. And that's our solution. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to share it with your friends if they're struggling with the same issue. Or you can actually consider subscribing to the channel if you're new here and you find the content that's coming up helpful. Don't forget, if your country doesn't have any states in here, you can actually go to the WooCommerce repo and you submit for those states to be added to your particular country. Otherwise, enjoy yourself.